Hi guys, welcome back to Farming SA, and today we teach you how to drive a tractor. Hi guys, welcome back, and I'm standing here next to the Massey Ferguson 240 that I'm going to teach you how to drive today. I'm going to put the specs about the top speed, power, horsepower, kilowatt, all of those things up in the corner somewhere around here. And today I'm going to do, as I said in the title most probably, teach you how to drive this tractor. It's a rather easy process. It has two gear sticks, a left, and it's a two-wheel drive tractor, if you can see. It's the front wheel assist. One of the main things you have to check before you start your tractor is the oil levels. We're going to start with the most important one, and it's on the other side, the tractor. Focus next to your oil filter. It's your engine oil level. Now, let's see if you can see better. It's above the maximum mark on the oil dipstick, so it's at the right level. Next to check is the hydraulic levels of oil. It's here on the right side of the driver's seat. Now this tractor's hydraulic oil is a little bit low, but we don't use any hydraulic extensions or whatsoever. So it's only a lubricant on this tractor. Now, these tractors without the cap can get in either side or on either side. We have put a cushion here for protection because steel on your bumps ain't quite fun. Now this tractor has a clutch on the left side to compress in. As you can see, the pedal disengages the transmission from the engine. On the right side of your foot is your brakes. I'm just disengaging them. The right brake and the left brake. You can engage them and use them together. Then you have your foot throttle up there. In between your legs are two transmission sticks. The left one has your, I'm going to call it numbering ranges. The left top corner is reverse. The left bottom corner is first, right top corner second, and right bottom corner is third. Now the right stick has three ranges. Well, it's actually two range, but three positions. The top is low, the low range, middle is neutral, and bottom is high range. Now here on the dash is your engine RPM, fuel, battery amps, and your water temperature. Also has the hand throttle here. Sit up and down. Underneath the dash is your kill switch. Pull out to kill the tractor, push in to start it. And on the right side is your key switch. Now on the right side of your driver's seat is the lift controls. The lever the farthest away from you is the height. Here from the bottom is to lower the implement. And if you pull it up, it raises the implement. And the lever the closest to you is the hydraulic pump control. It has low pressure, high pressure, transport position, constant up, constant down. I usually leave it in between high and low pressure. And on the back of the tractor is the 3-point linkage. And on the left side is our little toolbox. Not all tractors have these. It's a customizable feature of the tractor. your air filter and exhaust.
Now, if you're going to be driving this tractor, it's rather important, to know these two caps.
The one closest to the driver's side of the tractor is your fuel cap. And now you can see anything in there. And front is your coolant. Let's get this tractor running and go head out for an old alfalfa field where we can test drive it. So to start this tractor up, you need to push the clutch in all the way down. Make sure your gear sticks are in neutral. This one must move freely and this one must be in the middle position. Get off a little bit of gas. Make sure the kill switch is pushed in, not pulled out. Turn the key, see water pressure gauge is on. Make sure the free point is down for no unnecessary injuries. And then we can start it up. And lower gas. We are in our oats field right now. And I'm going to show you how to take off with a tractor and the gears. Now the tractor is already running and they showed you how to get it to this spot. Now, when you want to take off with a tractor, push the clutch in. Select the range. I'm going to check low, because low is best for beginners. And first gear, if you want to move forward, if you want, and then you slowly release your foot off of the clutch and see it, the tractor takes off. Now this is a really slow gear, but if you're a beginner, this is the best way to learn. If your steering wheel here, tractor steering wheels are in usual rather quite a bit larger than car steering wheels, and this tractor isn't power steering, so it takes lots of power to turn it. Now when you want to come to a still stand, push the clutch in and brake with both pedals of the brakes, right and left. Take the tractor out of gear. Now let's say you want to move in reverse. Make sure nothing is behind you. All clear. Put the gear stick in reverse and same as forward, release the brakes and slowly take your foot off the clutch, and there we go. Now same as forward to stop, clutch in, brakes. Now tractors can make a rather sharp turn to you with using these brakes. Now the right brake, if I push it in and I turn my steering wheel all the way to the right, I can make a sharp right. Let's show you. Put it in first high, push the brake in and slowly let off the clutch. You see, turning on the spot, this wheel is barely turning, but everyone is moving. And if I want to keep on my lane, I'm in. Release the brake and there I go, straight again. We're on our farm track here, straight down here. We're going to test our shifting gears here. We're going to take off in first high for road range. Give a little bit of gas and slowly let off the clutch. Now if you want to shift your gears, you have to push in the clutch. Select your gear. If you are in first high, you'll go to second high. And from second high, we'll go to third high. Push in the clutch, select gear and release. And that's how we can shift. Down this track, we can shift from first to third. Turn around and come back. First high, slowly off the clutch. There we go. Clutch in, second high. stupid. Now when the time comes to stop the tractor, push the clutch in when you stop, take it out of gear, the second one in neutral, lower the back by pushing the lever down here on the side. You take the gas away, take the kill switch, pull it out, and turn the key off. Now we've come to an halting stop of the tractor. I hope you could find this tutorial rather useful for yourself learning how to drive a tractor, especially a Massey Ferguson 240 in detail now. And I hope these tips help you to be more safe around tractors and do this properly. One of the biggest safety concerns around tractors is people not knowing how to stop them if there's ever any problem on the tractor, anywhere, anytime. Pull the kill switch. If it doesn't want to come to a halting stop or something goes horribly wrong, then try jumping off the side of the tractor, because you'll land underneath these large tires and they'll definitely kill you. So try and jump off the back and avoid the implement if there is an implement on the back. That's the safest way to escape the tractor death. Now, I hope this was really useful for you. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell button to get notifications for whenever Farming SA uploads a video. See you next time.